somebody in the morning, and they go and fight them in the evening, that'd be considered somewhat improper. And they're purposefully drawing out these negotiations to give these young men ample opportunity to calm down. They don't want them just rushing into these things headstrong. They want them to be able to rationalize their own mortality. Hopefully, this gives them the time, on an emotional level, to be capable of doing that. Alright, so, for those of you who came here today, expecting to see the Hollywood version of this, you might be disappointed. Have you ever seen a duel in the movies?
No.
It's not too difficult. I'll show you over there. All right, let's come out here. All right, go ahead and talk to the pistol. There you go. Now, point it up in the air like that, and step back to back with me. Or with me. Back to back with me. All right. You've all seen it, right?
This is in the air, back to back.
Then a voice of narration, in this case, the audience, starts counting from 1 to 10, if you will.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
All right. Now, I think we're actually still a little bit close to each other. I think the actual movie distance would look more like, stop, more like this. Now, I want you to keep this distance that we're at right now. Keep this image burned in the back of your head. I want you to remember just how far away this is. Because I have some bad news for the romantics among you. That never happened. What you just saw is complete fiction. Because based on the actual research I'm doing from the experts I know, they cannot find a single instance in history where it was ever done in that fashion. No, that's pure theatrics prepared by Hollywood. Look good for you on a screen, a Hollywood hizzle, so to speak. And it does look good on the screen. But it's not how this was actually done. So therefore, we're gonna go ahead and show you the historical method here today, at least for this time and place. You'll find it's a bit more direct and potentially even more dramatic than that. So, let's get to it. Let's assume at this point all negotiations for peace between us failed. What'll happen? I'm gonna show up with my second on my side of the field for a designated time. You'll do the same. This is the first time that we've been allowed to see each other or be near each other since our altercation. Even though we can very plainly hear each other right now, we're still not allowed to talk directly. We must still communicate through our seconds. Speaking of which, the code gives us one last chance to get out of this without having to resort to violence to do it. So, the seconds would meet in the middle of the field. And I want you to ask my second, can this not be peacefully reconciled? Alright, so when that question is raised, either party were to say no, we can't settle this peacefully. Well, the rules are clear. Now, you must proceed to a fire before you're allowed
12-16.
To again. So on that exchange that just happened there, we have for the first time locked ourselves into combat.
This will
now
repeat.
We have to fight. Yeah. So at this point, the field is prepared. So I'll mark this point down. Then usually a second would mark off the paces, but I'm going to go ahead and do this for expediency's sake. The literature states each pace should be about 3 feet. So it's going to look like this. Well, I'll be walking that direction. You want me to step inside. Here you go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So, m'lady, if you will, take your phone.